Mulla Nasiruddin was a great scholar. His fame was spread all over the world. He used to be invited for lecture in very prestigious institutions. So once he was invited to deliver a lecture before a big gathering. So when Mulla appeared on the stage, he asked one question. Do you know about the topic on which I am going to speak? The audience said, no. Then Mulla said, I don't want to speak before such ignorant people. And he went off. Sometime later, he was invited before another gathering. And there, when he stood on the stage, he asked the same question. Do you know the topic on which I am supposed to speak? The crowd said, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Because they knew that if they say no, then Mulla will not deliver the lecture. And so they said, yes, we know the topic on which you are going to speak. On this, Mulla said, if you already know what I am going to speak, why should I waste my time? And he again decided not to speak and went off. After a couple of days, Mulla was asked again to deliver the lecture before that big gathering. This time, when he stood on the stage, he asked the same question. Do you know the topic on which I am going to speak? Now the people did not know what to say. So half of the people said, yes, sir, we know. Half of the people said, no, sir, we don't know. Then Mulla said, let those who know teach those who don't know. And again, he decided not to speak and went off. So friends, this is an interesting story of Mulla Nasiruddin. Mulla Nasiruddin's stories are very famous all over the world to deliver very deep message. Superficially, if you look at this story, it appears that Mulla Nasiruddin was a lazy person. He did not want to speak. So in all the three situations, he found some excuse not to deliver the lecture. And so one simple message is that those who don't want to do work will always find some excuse for not doing the work. You can't make them do the work. But there is much more deeper meaning in this story. The first part of the story, Mulla refused to deliver the lecture to those who did not know the topic. Friends, we sometimes speak to those people who are ignorant and they don't know anything about the topic. All our effort to teach those ignorant people is likely to go waste. We should not spend our energy before those people who are ignorant and they don't know anything about the subject. If you want to deliver, for example, a lecture on physics, will it make a sense if you deliver that lecture before the audience of humanity, or deliver a lecture of philosophy before the students of medicine? So you must always choose the right audience and only say something, teach something, preach something, educate someone who is interested and someone who has some knowledge on that particular topic. Let's now go to the second part of the story. There are many people in this world who believe that they already know everything. Their mind is full. They are totally unreceptive of any new things. You deliver your lecture, you put forth your point of view, you teach the best things of your life, and still they don't learn anything because their mind is already full. Don't waste your energy on such people. They may appreciate you superficially, but they are not going to accept your teaching because they believe that they already know everything. Now, let's come to the third situation. A wise person is someone who does not waste his energies in teaching something which is already known to some people. He must rather teach them the value of cooperation. In this world, we know something and we don't know something. And if we learn to cooperate with each other by sharing what we know, then we can educate ourselves without any external support or help. This is the best way to learn. We must learn from each other rather than expecting somebody to come from outside and teach us. So friends, with this interesting story of Mullah Nasruddin, we can acquire tremendous wisdom, and we can use this wisdom in simplifying our life and making the life of other people better.